Hello everyone, I Harmeet welcome you all on WS Cube Tech. So today we are going to talk about a very important topic, and that is Pinterest SEO. Whenever you try to use any social media platform, you have to do the social media optimization, and whenever you use a search engine, you have to do the search engine optimization. And as we have talked already that Pinterest is a social media as well as a search engine. So we have to do the social media optimization or the Pinterest social media search engine optimization, right? So first of all, let's get to know that what is search engine optimization. So basically Pinterest SEO, or we can say the normally Pinterest search engine optimization or social media optimization, involves optimizing your Pinterest profile and website, right? We are optimizing both the things, first our Pinterest account and our website, in order to generate more traffic from Pinterest. Or I would say you can generate more traffic from Pinterest or through Pinterest, like you can get more traffic to your website from the audience which is already on the Pinterest, right? So Pinterest SEO will optimize our profile and our website also, right? So let's talk about what is the difference between Google SEO, Google search engine optimization, and Pinterest SEO. So on one hand, Google SEO is quite technical. There you have to learn on page and off page and technical SEO. You have to have the deep knowledge of Google. As you already know that Google considers almost 200 factors while ranking a website. But when we talk about Pinterest SEO, it is quite easy, and there are like few steps. If you have like basic knowledge of Pinterest and you follow few steps, right, which we will talk in this video, then you will be able to customize, you will be able to optimize your search engine, that is Pinterest, right? So in the only difference Google SEO and Pinterest SEO has is the complexity, right? Jo Google SEO is really complicated and very much complex, but Pinterest SEO is quite easy, and we are gonna talk about it, right? So let's get started. Today I'm gonna tell you few tips, few methods from that you can optimize your search engine, that is Pinterest, right? So let's get started. So the first step I want to give you to is that you have to optimize your profile, right? Profile optimization is the number one step that you have to follow while doing Pinterest SEO. The second thing is SEO friendly profile name. When we are optimizing our profile, then there are few things that we have to manage. Let's see what I'm talking about. So as you can see, this is our profile and this is our name, right? If you like consider it, then we have put our name like WS Cube Tech Digital Marketing and Web and App Development, right? So number one tip that you have to customize your profile in, and you have to put a SEO friendly name, that is the keywords. We have talked about keywords in our previous video, that was a keyword analysis, right? So do watch this video. In this video, we are going to talk about how to place those video in order to optimize your search engine, in order to optimize your Pinterest, right? So the first thing you have to do is you have to put a SEO friendly profile name, right? We have put our name like WS Cube Tech, so that all the things related to our content, all the keywords that are related to our content we are providing, content that is in our websites, right? So I have put all the keywords there like WS Cube Tech, this is our profile's name, then the digital marketing, that's related to our content, and the web and app development, right? And the second thing, like after profile name, there would be this description. You have to put your description in a way that more and more keywords of which we have analyzed, we have researched, should be placed here, right? So your description should also consist few of the keywords, right? So if you read our description, there are few keywords that we have inserted here, like WS Cube Tech offers services like web development, web designing, Android and iPhone app development, and digital marketing services, right? So we have done that, all right? And you have to customize, you have to optimize your profile by doing some few settings, right? If you haven't watched this video, Pinterest settings, then do watch it. There we have claimed our website, Instagram and YouTube. These are like basic things that you have to do, and in that way you will be able to optimize, or we can say customize, your profile, so you will get high reach, right? Whenever anybody will search digital marketing, there are chances that my post or my profile will be there, right? So this is our first step, optimize your profile. And we're going to talk more about how you can optimize your profile. And the one thing I have told you that put a Pinterest friendly or SEO friendly name that I believe I have clear you in this time, right? So you have to put your name like there should be some keywords. Okay, so the another step of doing SEO, Pinterest SEO, is verify your website. You have to verify your website over Pinterest. We have already talked about it. There's a separate video for that. Then do watch it. Then the other thing is claim other social media platforms. You have to claim other social media platforms over Pinterest. We have talked about it. There is a video like Pinterest settings. In that video, we have talked about what and how you can claim over the Pinterest. So it would be really easy to manage all the social media platform together, right? And verifying your website is really important, because as I have told you, the major feature that Pinterest has is that you can link any URL, any website page, or any link with any of your posts over Pinterest. So this is a major feature of Pinterest. So you have to verify your website. If you do not have a website, do not worry. You can attach your profile link or Instagram link or your YouTube link to your post, right? So this is our third tip, that to verify your website. And our next tip would be to attach all your social media platforms with Pinterest, or we can say you can claim all other social media platforms over Pinterest. And the other things would be like next thing that is very, very, very important, that create relevant boards. You have to create relevant boards. If you are a food blogger and you are making something related to North Indian cuisine, then you have to make a board that specify that this in this board there are recipes which are North Indian cuisine. Or if you are making something Italian, then there should be another board for that, right? If you are making something with the rice, then there should be another board. So relevant boards are really very important. I'm gonna show you how. So in the search engine, I'm gonna just search anything related to my field. For example, I'm gonna search something about digital marketing. All right, so I'm searching here digital marketing, and from there, like, see, there are so many posts, but why these posts have ranked like in the first row? Why these posts ranked first, right? There must be a reason, right? So I'm gonna open the first post that occurred here, right? As you can see that here, you can see how many times the digital marketing or marketing word has repeated, right? As you can see, this is the image, or in that image, there are so many text has been overlaid, and you can see this is social media, right? And if you read the title, the name of this profile, the person who have posted it, his profile name is Bootcamp digital marketing digital media training. You can see our keyword digital marketing has been placed there, and digital two times digital word has been placed there, right? So from this profile, I can prove that you have to put keywords in your profile name, right? So that would be a number one tip that I've already told you. And there's another important thing which I wanted to show you. The person who have saved it, he has saved it in a board. And board, the name of this board is social media. So you can understand this post has ranked first. And we can say the profile name of that person contains keywords. And the board is relevant, right? Because digital marketing is a part of social media, right? So that's how I can prove myself that this is a very important step in SEO, that you put your keywords in your profile name as well as in your description, and as well as the board should be the relevant, right? You can see that this is the another post that occurred there. So you can see the person who posted it, his name contains some of the keywords like big income paradise, social media marketing tips, make full-time income from home, right? So marketing tips is there, social media is there, social media marketing is a type of digital marketing. And you have seen here the person who have posted it, it's in content strategy, right? So relevancy of board and the keywords in your profile name and your description is must, right? Let's see some other examples also. All right. So let's see that this person who have posted it, you can see that on this particular image, the text has been overlaid and it is written that digital marketing. And if you see, this is the title of this post, the 15 plus amazing tools for digital marketers, and the name of this profile is somewhat related to the digital marketing or blog marketing. And the most important thing is that that person has saved that particular post in a relevant board, that is digital marketing tools and tech, right? So this would be another tip for you, that you have to create the relevant posts if you want high reach to your post. Okay, so more SEO tips are for you that you have to aim for portrait images, right? I have already told you in the content creation or in the how to pin video that you can put any size of video, any video of any size, any picture of any size you can put on in Pinterest and it will accept it. But it will be recommended that you post 2:3 ratio size of picture, right? I'm gonna tell you why I'm telling you. So the more SEO tips are for you that you should aim for portrait images, right? I have already told you that Pinterest will accept any picture sizes or any video sizes for all the formats it will accept, but it will be recommended that you only aim for the portrait images, that is 2:3 ratio, right? I'll tell you why I'm telling you this. So here you can see that on search engine I have just typed it DIY, and you can see search beautiful post, and you can see there's an imaginary wall in front of us, and our goal would be to cover as much as we can, right? Because this is our timeline, the other people will also have their timeline. So we have to cover as much as wall we can cover, like for our audience timeline, right? So you can see this is a post and this is a very small post. Then this post has covered a lot of space for this particular wall, right? And this is the size of 2:3. This is also 2:3, right? And this is a ingrow. Though you can post any sizes of pictures, right, and videos of any sizes, any ratio, but I would still prefer that if you want a good growth to your content, then post only 2:3 sizes, right? Because this is what Pinterest is famous for. This is what we call a pin, right? So that it can cover your whole wall. Okay, so the another tip for you is to keep an eye on trending. Whatever is trending, just keep an eye on that. What kind of audience do you have? What your audience is demanding? What is trending right now on Pinterest? Just keep an eye on that. And there is a quick tip for that, how you can do that. I'll show you. So after creating the business account, you'll go to this audience insights, right? In analytics, this is an option, audience insight. And you can see that this is the audience insights. And from this is our personal, our own audience, right? But if you go to the all Pinterest users, right, you can see there is the details of all the audience which is presented on Pinterest, like globally all the people are there and what they want to see, right? The most popular categories and related interests of this audience are there, right? So the most popular categories are home decor, related to the food, drinks, art, beauty, right? And even there, further categories are there, like in home decor, people want to see about wall, room decor, exteriors, home accessories, right? So in food and drinks, people want to see about dessert, dairy, fruit, right? So you can see that this is your audience and these are the trends that they want to see, right? And here we have the age thing also, that how many people are of which ages, right? And the gender here also, right? Or the devices they use. So from this platform, this window, you can find out that what type of content you should make. You can find your niche also. If you just started on Pinterest, then you can find your niche also from here, right? And you can find out what type of content you want to make, right? So just keep an eye on trending. This is the very important if you want to do any SEO, be it the Google, be it the Pinterest, or any social media platform. If you want to optimize or achieve high reach, then you have to keep an eye on what is trending. Okay, so our important tip, a very, very important, and I have seen a very a high amount of results from this tip, and that is that you can add, use keywords and hashtags together, right? For example, you are posting something, just post something and put some keyword phrases, right? For example, I'm posting something to digital marketing, then I'll put my phrases like digital marketing, social media marketing, strategy, content, right? Some kind of these keywords I will use, and I will convert those keywords in hashtags also, right? So I will put my keywords and then I will convert them into the hashtags, and I'll put both of them like together. I'll show you a demo. Okay, so here's an example for you. This is a picture, and this picture is related to the wedding photography, right? I've made an account of wedding photography, right? So this is a picture, and this is a picture, and this is our title. Title is wedding photography, poses, ideas for the couples. I have pasted, I have saved this picture on the couple poses named board, right? So this is our description, right? If you look for the description, then here it is, right? So this is our description. I have added few key phrases, right? Keyword phrases, that is wedding photography, wedding ideas, couple poses, wedding, and how to find keyword, that we have already discussed in the keyword analysis video. So I have added few keyword phrases, and I have converted these keyword phrases to these hashtags, right? So I have converted these hashtags to over this hashtag. So you can see here I have put both keyword phrases and the hashtags, right? You can see, and these are almost same, right? So this is an important trick that you can apply in order to post your pictures to the high ranking, and you will get a great achievement from that, right? So I'll just save it. This is just to show you. Okay. So our next tip for you is to be consistent, and that would be our last tip, that be consistent, post regularly. You can use scheduling of pins, but be consistent. If you are posting like 2 posts a day, then post daily, but I would recommend that post 5 times a day. And our last tip would be that be consistent. Whether you post 2 posts or 3 posts 3 times a day, right? Then you have to be the consistent, right? Post daily. I would recommend that post at least 5 pins, 5 videos or 5 pictures in a day, right? And be consistent and give value to your audience, that if they will come back and see your content. And the more audience will come to your post, the most traffic on your website you will get, right? So be consistent and keep pinning, and just follow all these things. And keyword analysis video is really important. There you will get the knowledge of how to research the keywords, what are the good keywords, what keywords you don't have to follow, right? So the keyword should be according to your content and according to the trend, right? So we have talked about that. Then do watch that video. Description would be in link. And if this video was useful for you, then hit the like button. And if there's any suggestion, comment, then comment down this video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much.